let's see. Income of other person included in assessee's total income, or we can call it as clubbing of income. Okay, other people's income we have to attach with the assessee income. How the computation started? Okay, so just a general format. Okay, what the section says. So income of other person included in assessee's total income. Income of other person included in assessee's total income. Number one. So suppose assessee transfer the income only without transferring the asset. Upper source of income taxable in the hands of assessee only. Suppose my name is assessee. I am assessee. I am transferring the income to anybody without transferring the asset. Without transferring the asset, only income transferred. Who is the source? Who is the owner of the source of the income? Myself, assessee. So assessee's source of income is belongs to assessee only. Correct? No. Upper income only transferred. Asset not transferred. Section 60 says this is assessee's total income. Section 60. Section 61. Income arising from revocable transfer of assets. Section 61. Anytime the income can be, income arising from revocable transfer, anytime the asset can be revocable. I transfer the assets to you. When you obey my words, I will not revoke it. When you not obey my word, I will revoke it later on. Okay, right. Anytime revocation provisions are applicable, it is always taxable in the hands of assessee only. Revocation, cancellation. Cancellation. I just transfer the asset to you. Anytime I can cancel the transfer. Anytime, which means I am always, source of income always belongs to assessee only. Section 61. So income arising from revocable transfer of asset always belongs to assessee only. Assessee only. Next, section 62. Okay. Exception, section 62. Suppose same transfer by way of a trust, which is not revocable during the lifetime of the beneficiary. Okay. So I transfer the assets. By way of trust, during the beneficiary's life cannot be revoked. I transferred A, my name is A, I transferred asset to a trust asset to the beneficiary B till the lifetime. You can enjoy the benefits till the lifetime. I will not revoke it. So during the lifetime of the beneficiary, during the lifetime of the transferee, it is not taxable in the hands of assessee. It is taxable in the hands of beneficiary. It is taxable in the hands of transferee. Till B, okay, so till the lifetime of B, it will not be taxable to A, because A is a transferor, B is a transferee, beneficiary. Till the life of B, asset will not be revocable. Upper it is taxable only to B. Till the life of transferee, asset will not be revoked. Upper it is taxable in the hands of transferee only. Exception. So till the life of beneficiary, till the life of transferee, the assets will not be revoked, income will not be revoked. It is taxable only in the hands of transferee or beneficiary. Similarly, any transfer before 1st April 61 and not revocable after 6 years. Any transfer before 1st April 61 and not revocable after 6 years. Okay, before 61 and A transfer to B. After 6 years, no revocation. Before April 1, 61, so asset was transferred. No cancellation or revocation, at least 6 years. In this case, beneficiary only will be taxable. So at least 6 years, no revocation provision. Asset transfer before 61, at least 6 years, no revocation provision. It is taxable only in the hands of beneficiary only. Provided no direct or indirect income tax transfer, no direct or indirect income are derived, no direct indirect income. So are going to be, the transfer will get any benefit. The transfer will not get any benefit either directly or indirectly out of such income. That's a provision. That's it. Okay, right. So whenever any revocation arises, clubbing will apply. Anytime the asset will be transferred, upper revocation apply. Upper asset taxable in the hands of assessee only. Anytime revocation happening, it is taxable in the hands of assessee only. That's it. Next, point number two, spouse income. Suppose I'm controlling company, at least 20%, which means substantial interest. I'm controlling company, at least 20%, substantial interest. Similarly, suppose spouse income. Suppose my name is assessee, I'm controlling a company, substantial interest, at least 20%, controlling company. In this case, remuneration to spouse, from a concern in which individual has substantial interest. Okay. Which means I'm controlling a company at least 20%. My spouse having income, provided my spouse doesn't have any knowledge. In this case, it is taxable to me only. because I'm controlling the company, at least 20%. My spouse appointed the company. Spouse doesn't have any knowledge. Anyway, she is getting salary. It is taxable in the hands of myself only, myself. Because I'm substantially controlling my compound, controlling the company, at least 20%. My wife doesn't have any knowledge or skill, right? Suppose, same, I'm substantially controlling the company, 20% or more. But my wife having a technical knowledge, my wife have a professionally qualified, she's a graduate in engineering. Our clubbing provision will not apply. Clubbing provision will not apply. It is taxable only in the hands of my wife only. Because my wife is technically, she is a sound. Even though I'm controlling company by 20%, at least 20%, my wife is technically sound. My wife professionally qualified. In this case, it is taxable in the hands of my wife only. Clubbing cannot be happened. Clubbing will not be applicable. It is not taxable to me. It is taxable only to my wife. Reason, my wife technically qualified. Exception. Similarly, any income arising to spouse from asset, any income arising to spouse from an asset transferred without adequate consideration, Okay, I'm transferring the asset to my wife. I'm not getting any money from my wife. In this case, it is taxable only to me. Okay, because I'm not getting any money from my wife. It is taxable to me only, right? Similarly, suppose the wife is not living apart. Any asset transferred, provided wife not living apart, not divorced, not living apart. In this case, income arising out of such asset, it is taxable only to assessee only. There are two conditions. Okay, asset transferred to wife, no money received, taxable to assessee. Asset transferred to wife, provided wife not living apart. No divorce for wife, not living apart. Again, taxable to assessee only. Suppose, asset transferred to wife paid full money, full consideration. It is taxable to wife only. Any income arising out of such asset, taxable to wife only. Suppose, wife got divorced, living apart. Asset transferred by the husband to wife. Wife got divorced. Any income after divorce arising to wife, taxable to wife only, because already divorced. Wife paid full money. Wife got divorced. Living apart. Any income arising out of such income, such asset, taxable only to wife. That's it. Similarly, I'm transferring asset to AOP or anybody else. Without any consideration. Okay, I'm ready to sell my property to you. Provided, so can I give every month rental of 10,000 to my wife forever? I don't want the asset. You keep the asset with yourself. I don't want any money. Can you pay every month 10,000 to my wife? In this case, it is taxable to assessee only. Same logic. Income arising to any person or AOP from any asset transferred without consideration for the benefit of spouse. Husband means wife's spouse. Wife means husband's spouse. Okay, fine. Appo any asset transferred for the benefit of wife, it is taxable to assessee only. Any asset transferred to anybody else, provided you have part of the income transferred to my wife's beneficiary. In this case, taxable to assessee only. That's it. Similarly, minor income clubbed in the hands of parent whose income is higher. Minor income taxable in the hands of parent whose income is higher. Suppose father income 10 lakhs, mother income 20 lakhs. Minor income. It is taxable. It is to be clubbed in the hands of father or mother whose income is higher. Suppose mother income is higher. It is to be clubbed in the hands of mother. Father income is higher. It is to be clubbed in the hands of father. That's it. Provided per kid, 1,500 exemption the father can claim or the mother can claim. Whoever be the clubbing provision attracts, either father or mother can claim exemption 1,500 per child. Above clubbing income attracts first club, then claim exemption. First club, then claim exemption. Either father or mother, whose income is higher? First club. Then later on, 1,500 per child claim exemption. That's it. Provided. Suppose such a kid, income arising to the kid out of skill cannot be taxed, cannot be clubbed. It is to be taxed to the kid only. Income arising to the kid out of manual work, out of skill work, out of talent, out of specialized knowledge, not to be clubbed in the hands of father or mother, it is to be taxed separately. Suppose the kid won Adler Super Singer, 1 crore prize money given to kid. It is taxable in the hands of kid only, not to be clubbed in the hands of parents. Because special talent income. Similarly, the kid having a minor child, kid is a minor child, suffering disability, ATU, some kind of kidney disease, some other disease, mentioned diseases, an ATU. Apo, because ATU, there are two deductions. One is flat deduction, 75,000, partial disability. Full deduction, 1 lakh. There are two. So, two, two, flat deductions. In case of ETU disability, 70,000 partial disability. Full disability for the kid, 1,90,000 flat deduction. The kid can claim. Suppose kid to be taxed separately in two occasions, minor kids. So kid having a skill income, talent income, manual income, knowledge income, not to be clubbed to the parent, taxed separately for the kid. Suppose kid having a disability, not to be clubbed to the parents, tax separately. That's it. Two occasions, tax separately. That's it. Otherwise, to be clubbed in the hands of parent, so that such a parent can claim 1,500 per kid for any number of kids. So three kids, 1,503, she can claim exemption. That's it. Finally, son's wife. Any income transferred to son's wife, taxable in the hands of transferor only. Suppose father-in-law, Mr. A, transfer to son's wife, without adequate consideration. Okay. So father-in-law transfer the asset to son's wife. Okay, ma, I transfer the asset to you. You take the house property income. I don't want it. Then the source of income taxable in the hands of assessee Mr. A only. So any asset transferred to daughter-in-law, son's wife, it is taxable in the hands of transferor only, without consideration, transferor only. Point number one, son's wife, not son, son's wife. So any asset transferred to son's wife without consideration, taxable in the hands of transferor only, assessee only. Similarly, for the benefit of son's wife, asset transferred, taxable to assessee only. Any income arising to any person or AOP from asset transferred without consideration. Okay, you want trust, I'll transfer that trust to you. I transfer the asset to you, provided my son's wife had to be benefited. Can I give monthly rental of to son's wife? Then it is taxable in the hands of transferor only. So asset transferred or transferred, trust transferred. Okay, for the beneficiary is my son's wife. Beneficiary is my son's wife. Then it is taxable in the hands of transferor only, assessee only. That's it. Any son's wife transfer, benefit of son's wife directly to son's wife or indirectly to son's wife, taxable in the hands of transfer only. That's it. Let's see. Mr. Vasudevan gave a sum of 6 lakhs to his brother's wife on 14-6-2020. Mr. Vasudevan gave a sum of 6 lakhs to brother's wife and 14-6-2020. Okay, Mr. Vasudevan gifted some amount to his brother. Brother's wife. How much he gifted, Mr. Vasudevan, to brother's wife? 6 lakhs is gifted. Brother's wife gifted. Right. Okay. Similarly, 12-7-17, after one month, brother also gifted some amount to Vasudevan's wife. Brother wife, Vasudevan wife. How much transferred? Rupees. 5 lakhs transferred to Vasudevan's wife. 5 lakhs to Vasudevan's wife. 5 lakhs. Okay. Vasudevan transferred to brother's wife, 6 lakhs. Brother transferred Vasudevan's wife, 5 lakhs. Automatically, this amount become deposits, FD, in the bank. Vasudevan wife deposit the money in the FD, fixed deposit, FD. Similarly, brother wife also deposit in FD deposits. Automatically, it is going to get interest. Again, it is going to get interest. Okay. So, both the deposit banks, but Mrs. Vasudevan wife and Vasudevan brother's wife. Mrs. Vasudevan, Vasudevan's wife and brother's wife, they deposit respective banks on 1820 at 9% interest rate. Interest carries 9% interest rate. Carries 9%. From 1820 only, they deposited. August only they deposited in the bank. August, September, October, November, December only interest started. Examine the consequence of above transfer provisions, Income Tax Act, in the hands of Mr. Vasudevan and his brother. Okay. So when they invested 1820, interest amount. If you want interest amount, you can calculate it. Nothing wrong in it. 5 lakh into 9%. August 1 investment in FD. ஆகஸ்ட் செப்டம்பர் அக்டோபர் நவம்பர் டிசம்பர் ஃபைவ் மந்த்ஸ் ஃபைவ் மந்த்ஸ் பிளஸ் த்ரீ மந்த்ஸ் எயிட் மந்த்ஸ் எயிட் பை டுவெல் எயிட் பை டுவெல் எயிட் பை டுவெல் ஆகஸ்ட் செப்டம்பர் அக்டோபர் நவம்பர் டிசம்பர் ஜனவரி மார்ச் எயிட் மந்த்ஸ் ஹியர் இஸ் கோயிங் டு பி சிக்ஸ் லேக்ஸ் சிக்ஸ் லேக்ஸ் நைன் பர்சன்டேஜ் நைன் பர்சன்டேஜ் எயிட் பை டுவெல் எயிட் பை டுவெல் வாட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் அமௌண்ட் ஃபார் அண்டர்ஸ்டேக் ஆஃப் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் ஸோ ஃபைவ் லேக்ஸ் இன்ட்டு நைன் பர்சன்டேஜ் இன்ட்டு எயிட் பை டுவெல் ஐ திங்க் இட்ஸ் கோயிங் டு பி தேர்ட்டி தௌசண்ட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் தேர்ட்டி தௌசண்ட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் இல் செக் ஒன் மோர் டைம் ஃபைவ் லேக்ஸ் இன்ட்டு நைன் பர்சன்டேஜ் இன்ட்டு எயிட் பை டுவெல் பை டுவெல் ஸோ தேர்ட்டி தௌசண்ட் ஹியர் சிக்ஸ் லேக்ஸ் இன்ட்டு நைன் பர்சன்டேஜ் இன்ட்டு எயிட் பை டுவெல் பை டுவெல் பை டுவெல் ஸோ தேர்ட்டி சிக்ஸ் தௌசண்ட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் தேர்ட்டி சிக்ஸ் தௌசண்ட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் வில் செக் ஒன் மோர் டைம் வில் செக் ஒன் மோர் டைம் சிக்ஸ் லேக்ஸ் இன்ட்டு நைன் பர்சன்டேஜ் இன்ட்டு எயிட் பை டுவெல் பை டுவெல் தட்ஸ் ஸோ சிக்ஸ் லேக்ஸ் இன்ட்டு நைன் பர்சன்டேஜ் இன்ட்டு எயிட் பை டுவெல் பை டுவெல் தேர்ட்டி சிக்ஸ் தௌசண்ட் ஆகஸ்ட் செப்டம்பர் அக்டோபர் நவம்பர் டிசம்பர் எயிட் மந்த்ஸ் தேர்ட்டி சிக்ஸ் தௌசண்ட் ரைட் ஸோ ஓகே எனிவே கிஃப்ட் ஃப்ரம் ரிலேட்டிவ் நான் டாக்ஸபிள் gift from relative non taxable 5 lakh received by Vasudevan's wife from brother of Vasudevan non taxable because it's a gift it is a gift gift is non taxable so brother's wife getting 6 lakh from Vasudevan that is also gift that is also non taxable gift received from husband's brother gift received from husband's brother relative non taxable gift received from husband's brother relative non taxable the same gift if it is invested in the deposits it starts earning interest same gift it deposit interest it start earnings so here the interest accrued for 5 lakhs amount 30,000 here the 6 lakhs amount interest 9% 8 months 36,000 that's it now who is going to be taxable this method the circuit is going to be applicable it's called circuitous method is a method we are going to apply so Vasudevan to brother's wife brother to Vasudevan's wife so cross transfer Money has been cross transfer. Since they are cross transfer, automatically, it is taxable in the hands of cross transfer only. Out of 5 lakhs, any interest arises taxable to brother. Out of 5 lakhs, any interest arises to Vasudevan's wife, taxable to brother. Out of 6 lakhs, any interest arises, it is taxable to Vasudevan. So brother's wife ki out of 6 lakhs any interest starts taxable to Vasudevan out of 5 lakhs any interest arises taxable to brother appo 5 lakh interest 5 lakh rupees for 5 lakh rupees interest arises taxable to brother for 6 lakhs interest arises taxable to Vasudevan sum over that's it. So that's what they say is very clearly so Mr. Vasudevan gifted a sum of 6 lakh to brother's wife brother gifted 5 lakhs to Vasudevan's wife both amount they deposit in FD by Mrs. Vasudevan Vasudevan's wife and brother's wife it is called cross transfer so income from other transfer in the hands of deemed transferor which means so Vasudevan's wife income brother owner brother's wife income Vasudevan owner cross transfer intimately connected single transaction each transfer constitute consideration for the other for the mutual benefit if two transactions are interconnected same transaction by circuitous method you have to apply it is a device you have to apply to evade tax according to apex court supreme court says in commission income tax kesaji moraji case very clearly says clubbing provision attracted for the cross transferor so that's it any interest now working to mrs vasudevan okay similarly mrs vasudevan would be included in total income mr vasudevan An interest income arising against the brother's wife would be taxed in the hands of Mr. Vasudevan's brother to the extent of 5 lakhs. This is because Mrs. Vasudevan and brother are indirect transferors of income, the respective spouses. Therefore, interest income earned by the spouse fixed above the 5 lakhs would be included in the hands of Mr. Vasudevan's brother. That's it. Very important. Okay, Vasudevan's brother, 5 lakhs. That's very important because Vasudevan transferred brother's transfer to only 5 lakhs to Vasudevan's brother anyway taxable income portion for a brother 5 lakhs income only 5 lakhs only income to be computed for Vasudevan 6 lakh transferred 6 lakh only taxable in the hands of Vasudevan cross transfer anyway taxable in the hands of respective spouses so interest earned by the spouse on fixed deposit 5 lakhs would be included in the hands of Vasudevan's brother. Reason, Vasudevan transferred, Vasudevan's brother transferred only 5 lakhs only. Up income, up automatically, 5 lakh rupees, what will be the income? It is taxable to brother. 6 lakh rupees, what will be the income? It is taxable to Vasudevan. It's called cross transfer, cross transfer. That's it. Now let's see. Mr. Sarma has four children. Consists of two daughters, two sons. They are a minor only, I think, minor only. Two daughters, two sons. The annual income of two daughters, 9,000, 4,500. And sons, 6,000 to 4,300. Daughter has an income of 4,500. Suffering from a disability under ATU. She is a disabled, paralytic attack, or blind, 100% blind, disabled. Of any disability, that kid has to be taxed separately. She is having a lot of deductions available. Okay. Anyway, whose income is going to be taxed? Your father only given, Sharma only given. Anyway, it is to be taxed in the hands of Sharma only. Every income is going to be taxed in the hands of Sharma only. Sharma only, Mr. Sharma. Sharma. Two daughters, D1, D2. Two sons, son 1, son 2. Income. Daughter 1, they are all minor daughters. Minor daughter only, minor D1. Not 18 years completed, minor daughter 2. 18 years not completed. Minor son 1, minor son 2, Okay, income. Here 9,000 income. 4,500 income. 6,200 income. 4,300 income. But daughter 2, disabled. She is a disabled. She is disabled. ATU benefits. What is ATU benefits? 70% flat deduction, 100%. 70% partial disability reduction, 120,000, 100%. In case of partial disability, 70,000 we can reduce it. Flat deduction for assessee, D2. In case of full disability, 120,000 we can reduce it from her income. We can either subtract the ATU for a daughter, either 70,000, she is partially disabled, or ATU, we can claim, deduction can be claimed by the daughter, 120,000 in case of full disability. 80% above disability, full. Below 80% partial disability. From her income, she can reduce either 75 or 1 lakh. So both the benefits she is availing. Anyway, not to be clubbed to father. No clubbing provision for minor daughter 2. But that minor daughter 1, yes, clubbing starts 9,000 minus 1,500. Section 10, 32, 1,500. Subtract, balance 7,500. Income. Similarly, minor daughter S1, 6,200, please club, 6,200, minus 1,500, 62 minus 1,500, 6,200, minus 1,500, 4,700, to be clubbing provision attracts. This is for D1 daughter clubbing, this is S1 clubbing, D1 clubbing, is S1 clubbing in the hands of Mr. Sharma only, and S2 club end next S1 clubbing over, then S2 also. Everything in the hands of Sharma only. Sharma only we have to club. First child 1,000. Similarly, S2 income 4,300. S2 income minus clubbing 1,500. So 4,300 minus 1,500, that's going to be 2,800. That's it. 2,800. Total income of Sharma, 7,500 plus 4,700 plus 2,800. That's it. So 15,000 income to Sharma. So anyway, Mr. Sharma income 15,000. D2 daughter to be taxed separately. This income 4,500 to be taxed separately. That's it. So 15,000. Anyway, Mr. Sharma income. So Mr. Sharma income 15,000. That's it. So four children. One of the kid either special knowledge or experience or any disability, clubbing does not arise. Anyway, all the incomes of minor children to be clubbed in the hands of Sharma only. Per kid, she can claim 15,000. 1,500 per kid. 1,500 per kid, she can claim. Section 10, subsection 32. That special kid should not be clubbed because she shall have a disability. Shall not be clubbed. So balance is 15,000 total income. First daughter 1,500. Second one more, second son, third son, second two sons income minus 1,500. First son, second son. Son income, son two income. 1,500. So balance is 15,000 income. This is to be clubbed in the hands of Mr. Sharma. 15,000 is a Sharma's income only. Sharma's income only 15,000. Sharma's income 15,000. That's it. In the hands of Sharma, it is going to be rupees 15,000 taxable. 15,000 taxable income for Sharma. Mr. A gifted a house property valued 50 lakhs to his wife, Mrs. B. Mr. A gifted a house property valued 50 lakhs to his wife, Mrs. B. She in turn gifted the same to Mrs. C, a daughter-in-law. The house was let out 20,000 per month throughout the year. Compare the total income of Mr. A and Mrs. C. First question. Appa A, husband transferred to wife. Wife transferred to daughter-in-law. That house, from the house, she is getting income of 20,000 per month throughout the year. Who is going to be taxable? Mr. A, Mrs. C or wife? Either father or wife or father-in-law or mother-in-law or daughter-in-law. Who is going to be taxed? First question. Second question. The same property gifted by Mr. A to his son. Instead of son's wife, son, then who is going to be taxable? Very simple logic. Okay. Anyway, any income arising directly or indirectly to the benefit of son's wife, taxable in the hands of original transferor only. Original transferor. A gifted to Mrs. B. Mrs. G gifted to daughter-in-law. Who is the original transferor? Mr. A only. Mr. A only original transferor. Now it is taxable only to Mr. A original transferor. How much income taxable? Property gift. How much income taxable? House property income, HP income. So 25,000 into 12. So that is equal to 3 lakhs. Minus section 24A. Standard action 30% says 3,30,000, 90,000 standard action. Up to 2,10,000 taxable in the hands of Mr. A. He's a original transferor. That's it. Mr. A. Okay, right. First question, Mr. A. So individual who transfer to otherwise for adequate consideration, there is no consideration here. Free only, gift only. Okay, not being living apart. Yes, no, not living apart. Why separately even? No. Not living apart. No money received. In this case, Mr. A deemed one of such house property to his wife, Mrs. B, without consideration. 64.16 says, income arising to son's wife, from assets transferred, directly or indirectly, to heir by an individual, otherwise for adequate consideration, would be included in the hands of such individual. And who is such individual here? Mr. A only. Mr. A transferred the gift to wife. Wife transferred to the son's wife. Any original transfer, Mr. A. It is transferable to Mr. A only. How much income? 2,10,000. To such individual. 2,10,000 taxable. Mr. A, it is taxable. First question. Second question. Same property transferred to son. Sorry, sir. It is taxable in the hands of son only. Son. Same property transferred to son, it is taxable to son only. So there is no special provision for transfer to son. Okay, right. Anyway, the income arising to such property gifted to son, it is taxable only to son. That's it. In case 2,10,000 property transferred to Mrs. C, son's wife, would be included in the hands of Mr. A by using the provision of 27.1 and 64.16. It is not taxable in the hands of daughter-in-law. Taxable only to father-in-law. Mr. A, it is taxable. Suppose same property gifted to A's son. Clubbing provision will not be attracted. No clubbing provision. Previous one, clubbing provision in the hands of A. Mr. A, father-in-law. Here, no clubbing provision. Will not applicable. Therefore, no clubbing provision. Since son is not a minor child, no clubbing provision. Therefore, income of 2,10,000 for letting out the property gifted to son, taxable in the hands of son only. That's it. No clubbing provision. Income arising to such son, it is taxed in the hands of son only. Suppose son is a minor, then clubbing attracts. Son is a not minor, no clubbing attracts. It is taxed in the hands of son only, son only. First case, daughter-in-law transfer, father-in-law transfer, father-in-law taxable. Daughter-in-law transfer, father-in-law taxable. Second one is son taxable, therefore father, son transfer, therefore taxability in the hands of son only, son only. Any transfer to daughter-in-law, income taxable to father-in-law. Any transfer to son, income arises taxable in the hands of son only. That's it. A property business was started by Srimati Rani in the year 2018. 1/4/19, her capital in the business was rupees 3 lakhs. Capital in the business was rupees 3 lakhs. Rupees 3 lakhs. Her husband gifted 2 lakhs on 10/4/19. The sum is invested by Srimati Rani in her business on the same date. Same date she invested. She already she running the business from 2018 onwards. Anyway, from 1/4/19, Srimati Rani. And husband. 1/4/19, as on 1/4/19, capital for Srimati Rani, 3 lakhs. Okay, husband did nil. So 10/4/19, husband gifted, 10/4/19, husband gifted 2 lakhs, husband gifted. Any gift coming from husband, it is husband's capital. It's a gift, it's not a loan, husband's capital. Anyway, 1920 financial year, she earned any income? Yes, she earned income 1,50,000. Anyway, so 31/3/19, 31/3/20, anyway, she's having a profit of 1,50,000. This profit belongs to wife only, 4.5 lakh. And now middle of the husband invested. Opening lele. As for opening capital, it is their income only. 1.5 lakhs income earned. Anyway, husband is middle of the year only husband invested. Opening capital, Rani only there. Appa, this is Rani's income only. Opening capital belongs to Rani only. No husband opening capital. Anyway, this 1.5 lakhs belongs to Rani only. Rani only. 4.5 lakhs year is going to be 2 lakhs. Middle of the year, any husband gifted, it is not husband's income, it is only Rani's income, right? This is the capital on 1/4/20. This is opening capital. After profit added, it is opening capital, right? Now 2021 financial year, again profit starts. What is the profit, ma? Second financial year, 2020 financial, 3,90,000. So 3,90,000 profit. Anyway, this profit will be transferred between husband and wife, Rani and husband. The ratio of 4.5 lakhs is to 2 lakhs. 45-20 ratio, we have divided. 45-20 ratio. Okay, right. So profit 3,90,000. We have to distribute 45-20 ratio. So 45-20 ratio, we have to divide. So 3,90,000 into 45/65. 45-20. 4.5 lakhs to 2 lakhs. 45-20. So 3,90,000 into 45 by 65. So 2,70,000 profit belongs to Srimati Rani. Right. So 3,90,000 into 20/65. Balance it. Into 20/65. Belongs to husband. That's it. Ma, please add, ma. 4,50,000 plus 2,70,000, ma. 7,20,000. Ma, please add, ma. 3,20,000. That's it. So this is the capital as on 31/3/21. So closing capital. The question is, how the taxability for 1920, 1.5 lakhs is taxed in the hands of Mrs. Rani. For 2021, 3,90,000 profit, 2 lakhs is taxable in the hands of Srimati Rani. So 1 lakh is taxable in the hands of husband only. This is the taxable income for 2021. So 2,70,000 taxable to Srimati Rani. 1,20,000 taxable to husband. That's it. Suppose same amount gifted, same case two, Srimati Rani, husband of Srimati Rani. 1/4/19, opening capital. So opening capital 3 lakhs, Srimati Rani. Okay. Assumption two. 10/4/19. Okay. Gifted, sir, gifted, not, it's not a gifted. My point is second case two is a loan. Instead of gift, it was a loan. It's not a gift, loan. It's a loan. It's a loan. Loan. Case 2, loan. Husband has given loan. So loan amount. Loan amount. So loan of 2 lakhs. It is not a gift, loan. Loan means husband will get interest from wife. That's it. Okay, right. Anyway, 1920 profit belongs to, anyway, 19, not only 1920, any year profit belongs to Srimati Ramani because she got a loan from husband, not gift. Gift in husband having share in the profit. Loan to husband, no share in the profit. Anyway, 1920 profit for Srimati Ramani, 1 lakh 50. That 1 lakh 50 belongs to Srimati Ramani only always because she got a loan from husband. Anyway, 4.5 lakhs. Year, nil. So, 1420 opening capital to Srimati Ramani, 4.5 lakhs. 4.5 lakhs, right. So, profit for 2021 financial year. 2021 financial year, profit is 390,000. That profit belongs to, 390,000 belongs to Srimati Ramani only. Srimati Ramani only, that's it. So, 4.5 lakhs plus 390,000, 8 lakh 40. Profit not belongs to husband. Husband is always nil. Anyway, this is going to be opening capital year after for Ramani. So, 1421 opening capital for Ramani. In case to husband, in case to from husband, Ramani got loan. From husband, Ramani got loan. Husband, Ramani, she got a loan. Okay. Got a loan of rupees 2 lakh. That's the idea. Rupees 2 lakh. That's the idea. Okay. Right. Case 2 is also over. Suppose in case of loan, whatever the profit Ramani earning, it is taxed in the hands of Ramani only. It is not taxed in the hands of husband. Because she got a loan from husband in case 2. Correct? No, that's it. Anyway, the first year income, tax in the hands of Ramani only. Second year profit, tax in the hands of Ramani only. Suppose if Ramani got loan from her husband. It is not supposed to tax in the hands of husband. Because it's a loan only, no. Case 1, it is a gift from husband. Case 2, it is a loan. If it is a loan, no part of profit will be shared to husband. That's it, ma. Okay. Anyway, first year profit, owner, Ramani. Second year profit, owner, husband, wife will distribute. Husband will take care. Husband, wife. Husband 2 lakh 70, wife 1 lakh 20, anyway 3 lakh 90, both will take. 3 lakh 90, out of 3 lakh 90, husband will take 2 lakh 70, wife will take, Srimati Ramani will take 2 lakh 70, husband will take 1 lakh 20. If it is a gift. If it is a loan, this is the case. If it is a gift, this is the case. First year, second year treatment. Always on opening capital, profit should be shared. Opening capital, profit will be shared. Opening capital here, 3 lakhs. Entire profit belongs to Ramani only. Here, opening capital, 4.5 lakhs, 2 lakhs. Anyway, capital to be distributed in the opening capital ratio. 20-40-20 ratio, we have to divide. That's it.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Stride Digitech, and press the bell icon to see new videos.